get back to the gym and get some sparring in, and yeah, be ready.
There's talk she's definitely going to come to fight.
I fought, we both fought Farias, which is a brilliant fighter. And I actually thought Farias was going to beat Mikalski. So Mikalski beating Farias, a world champion, so seasoned, so good in experience, that was a big deal. That was huge. So I think those who have followed boxing and followed the women's boxing for a while, they know that this is going to be a real tough fight. And those who haven't are the ones who are saying that, you know, this will be just a walkover, and then she'll be ready for her next challenge. And that's definitely, Mikalski is definitely not someone you're overlooking. And I'm not doing that either.
Well, obviously, at the moment, everyone's talking about future fights with Serrano and Taylor, and we'll come on to that in a minute. That's what everybody is messaging, talking about right now. I have to bring up Clarissa Shields because, you know, she's relentless. I mean, I felt sorry for you the other day on Twitter because I know you're quite quiet. You don't really like any beef, and she's good for boxing because she doesn't stop. You know, she's like on social media all day. She's achieved a great deal as well, but she's just, you know. She's on you, isn't she? She is on you. She wouldn't let go the other night.
I think she has a little bit crush on
Yeah, it's
me.
quite possible.
No, but you know what you said there? I 100% agree. Clarissa is good for boxing. You know, she brings excitement, and she brings the fans in, and they get very you know, caught up in the whole thing. So she is a good thing for boxing. She's still young, and she's still learning how things working out. You know, I've been doing this for a while now. So of course, I've been through a lot of ups and downs, and it's not the first time I've been in tough weather. Clarissa, you know, I think I pointed out to everyone why this isn't happening right now, because I'm in a foursome that is quite extraordinary. Like this mini tournament with me, Mikalski, Katie Taylor, and Amanda Serrano, and that's something that you know, it would take a lot to drag me away from this, to be part of this all world champion, all, you know, potential Hall of Famers. It's quite an astonishing situation right now in women boxing. And for me, coming starting out when we were not allowed to go to the Olympics, and yes, the whole boxing thing being quite different, I think for me this is a little bit it's a little bit different maybe than the girls who went to the Olympics and then went straight to the big promoters and TV screens. I think this has a little bit different meaning for me being a part of all this.
Well, of course, one of the reasons that boxing for women did move into the Olympics was Katie Taylor and her push for that and the Olympic trials and stuff like that. Her fight was due to take place on May the early in May, May the 2nd, with Amanda Serrano. That's now looking like July. I want you just to give me a little bit of analysis on that fight. I've watched Amanda Serrano a few times now on our shows. I think she punches very hard. She's extremely confident. A few people think that could be a tougher fight than expected for Katie Taylor.
Yes, for me, it's a totally open fight. It's 50-50. I cannot for anything pick a winner here, because they are so good with what they're doing. You know, Katie Taylor is so brilliant, she's technical, and she's so fast, has a great footwork. Serrano, she's strong, you know, she's relentless, and she's also a pretty good she's also a good technical and smart fighter. I just it's going to be amazing. It's going to be an amazing fight, and I'm so looking forward to this fight. And then you have the winner of both these fights
Well,
meeting
that's a
each
natural,
other.
yeah. I mean, basically, the winner of you and McCaskill and the winner of Taylor Serrano is a done deal, really, isn't it? I mean, it's an absolute must. The biggest fight in women's boxing. But when you talk about your weight for that fight, obviously the fight with McCaskill is at 145,
Yes.
and Katie won a world title at 140. she struggled to make 140, or she struggled to reach 140 rather than make it. So you think you could come down a pound or two, or you know, around from 145 to get that on?
Yes, I don't have a problem with that at all. I'm a small welterweight, you know. I walk around as a welterweight. I shouldn't be a problem at all.
Good. And just lastly, Cecilia, obviously you were responsible for the growth of women's boxing in the professional ranks. Just incredible right now to see not only the growth of women's boxing, but also, and we know that there isn't financial parity yet between the women and the men, but we are, you know, we're really making strides and we're getting it. And I think the mega fights are going to start seeing that big money, and you deserve it. You know, I think that I always say that in the press conferences, I don't look at it as men's boxing and women's boxing. It's just boxing. It's a TV product for fans and broadcasters. And if it's entertaining,